They say a change is as good as a rest, so for this outing I decided to take the guppy to Loch Fyne and have a day out there. I left home at sunrise and the temperature gauge in the car read -6 degrees. When I arrived at Loch Fyne, which is a sea loch, the ice-covered loch surface made me shudder with cold, so I decided to continue on to Loch Goil, which I hope would be ice-free as the salt content in the water there is a bit higher. Loch Goil is around 40 miles from my home, so not too far to go. And to get there from Loch Fyne, I headed for the summit of the Rest and Be Thankful, the notorious section of the A83 road, often closed due to landslips. There was no traffic problems this day, and I stopped to let the drone have a sniff around, although this footage was taken my way home instead of the way there. As you can see, it was a lovely late winter's day, bitterly cold with little wind. Blue sky with hardly a cloud to be seen. A clear atmosphere which made the hills look sharp and with their tops covered in white snow. I couldn't ask for a better boating day, and I was really looking forward to seeing Loch Goil and Loch Long again, as it had been over 5 years or so since I was last there. I wondered if I'd noticed much change to the area. I drove down the single track road to Loch Goil Head Village, only to discover the tide was full out and a long way to carry all the boat bits to the sea. However, I had checked the tide times before coming, so was prepared. I also carried my small collapsible trolley in the car. I set up the guppy in the car park beside the car and then trundled the boat across the shore. I then put the trolley back in the car and launched the drone so it could see the car park, the beach access and the lovely village of Loch Goil Head. Once the drone landed, I clambered into the boat, started up the outboard and slowly headed past the moored boats to deeper water. I kept the outboard and tick over to give it time to warm up, as it was bitterly cold in the water this day. Passing a large yellow marker buoy reminded me that the restricted areas in both Loch Goil and Long, their access is not allowed due to MOD facilities. In Loch Goil, the areas are marked with these buoys. If in doubt, following the western shores, avoid these areas. This map shows the route I took. Loch Goil is home to some underwater sonic testing equipment, and Loch Long has Coalport Nuclear Submarine Base and Finnart Oil Terminal. This still shot shows the four buoys marking one of the restricted areas in Loch Goil, so you can see they're easily identified assuming you know what they're for. If you choose to ignore the buoys and enter any restricted areas, especially around Coalport, be prepared to meet the MOD police, and whatever you do, don't let them see your camera. Because I had not been in Loch Goil for a few years, I was interested to see if there were many changes. The first most notable change to me was the treehouse at this hotel, famed for wedding functions, was no longer there. I wondered if the storms had brought the tree down. The second obvious change for me was I always enjoyed watching the large colony of seals, which normally haul themselves onto the rocks here at low water. I was most surprised to only see three. Seals don't migrate, so I wondered where they had gone. I searched the shores and only saw one more. Perhaps I was just unlucky or they were on holiday. The third obvious change came when it was time to land for a coffee. I always landed on a lovely shingle beach just around the corner from this locky shore. However, when I arrived at the normal stop, I discovered a new house had been built overlooking the shingle, and they had a small boat stored there, so I gave it a miss and just landed here. The drone positioned itself in a hover to watch me have my first coffee of the day, and this was the exact moment they found I'd left the coffee flask at home. I was almost in a panic, knowing that I'd not a drop to drink all day, so sat and sucked a banana, wondering what to do. Go home or continue on my way. I knew it could be a long day without my fix, but decided to keep on going, knowing I could hopefully get a coffee at Arracher, the village at the far end of Loch Long. It was a very dry banana, so once it was swallowed, I jumped back into the boat and continued down the loch. Water, water everywhere, and not a drop to drink. I continued ever onward until I reached Carrick Castle, a late 14th century stronghold, possibly built by the Campbells. I recall almost buying a small flat in the building behind the castle, around 12 years or so ago, as even then I wanted out the city, but decided against it, and I'm glad as I much prefer Loch Etive. Thank you. it was back to the boat and heading eastward towards Loch Long. A slight wave started to get up, caused by flowing tides against a slight breeze. Approaching a small lighthouse at the junction of Loch Goil and Loch Long, I half expected to see one of the MOD ribs approaching from Coalport. And I wasn't wrong. I'd only turned into Loch Long when I saw a rib leave Coalport heading my way. I didn't antagonise the situation by pointing cameras at them, and they lazily followed behind me. I guess when you're stuck in a boat all day and your job is to ensure the safety of Coalport, I too would check out any strange craft coming into the area, possibly through boredom, as there's no sign of other boats. Well, except the supertanker at Finnett Oil Terminal. Then he saw me land at Mark's cottage. I guess he knew I was not a threat and turned back to Coalport. I last stayed in the Bothy around 5 years ago on a cold January night. Myself and a mate had planned a quiet night at the Bothy. One other person was there when we arrived. Then three kayakers arrived, making a total of 6 people, which is cosy for a small bothy. Then another 4 cyclists arrived, just as it got dark. 10 in a bothy is overcrowded, and the noise of 9 pairs of snoring tonsils and the stench of stale beer didn't make for a quiet evening. In fact, they put me off bothies, and I have not stayed in one since. At least this bothy has not changed in the slightest. It was tidy, and although empty, I saw plenty of footprints in the mud outside, so presume it had a very busy weekend. I kept the drone in a tight leash, as I didn't want to attract the MOD boys back again. I didn't wait long either, as I was choking for a coffee, and although there was some left in the jar in the bothy, I'd no means of boiling water. I left and headed up Loch Long, dreaming of coffee at Arica. The stunning scenery, reflected in a mirror-smooth surface, eased my withdrawal symptoms, and I thoroughly enjoyed the journey. Ben Arthur, better known as the Cobbler, looked lovely in its white coat, high above the green trees. Not much has changed in Loch Long, and I was surprised to see the old torpedo range building still standing. It looks like there's a lot of good scrap iron there. The range was in operation from 1912 to 1986 before being abandoned. I believe they were planned to be demolished in 2007, but they mysteriously caught fire just before that, and it looks like no one has been near them since. From there, it was just a short hop, skip and splash across to Arica. Although I had a lovely day in the lochs, the highlight for me was I bought coffee in a wee shop. My withdrawal symptoms were gone. I had just as an enjoyable journey back to Loch Goil Head, going the same way as I'd come. This time round, the retrieval of the boat was easy as the tide was in. So I hope you enjoyed the video, and thanks for watching.